Hello everyone, welcome to session 32 of Software Testing Made Easy course. In this session, we are going to continue with the live project, that is part 24 of the Independent Software Testing Live Project, where I am going to show you an email which can be sent to the client with a list of defects and blockers. So let's get started, guys. So in the previous sessions, guys, in one of the previous sessions, I have shown you the completely executed test cases, and as part of this completely executed test cases, few test cases were passing, few test cases were failing, and few test cases we were unable to test because of blockers, right? There are different states that we have provided in these executed test cases as the results. So for the test cases which got passed, nothing to be worried. Whereas there were some test cases which were failed for which we have reported the defects, right? Even in one of the previous session, I showed you the list of complete defects that we have identified while executing the test cases, and after that we have also explored the application. As part of these two activities, we got some defects, guys. I have shown you the complete list of defects in the previous session. Now, as I already mentioned, when we executed the test cases, few test cases were blocked, guys. We were unable to test them because of some blockers, right? There are some things that were blocking us from testing the test cases, executing the test cases. I shown you clearly in the previous sessions. So now, guys, in this session, I am going to show you how to send a detailed status email to the client with all these details, okay? With whatever the execution that you have done so far, with whatever the blockers you identified so far in the particular test cases, and with whatever the list of defects you have identified, okay? In the first day, you executed few test cases and you reported two defects that I explained in one of the previous sessions. After that, you continued executing the test cases and you completely executed the test cases and you identified good number of defects, around like 21 defects you identified later, right? So all those list of defects along with the blockers in the test cases, how to send a detailed status email with all these details, guys. That thing I'm going to explain in this session, guys. So I have prepared the email already. So this is for your purpose, guys, because I cannot send you an email, right? So I just provided a kind of snapshot of my email. So you can open here like this and you can see the email, okay? A PDF version of the email. I just printed the email so that you can use it for your future reference. So this is the email, exact email we have sent to the client as part of reporting the blockers, defects, and all those execution related stuff, et cetera, et cetera. Now let me show you practically like how the email looks. So the client or client POC for whom you need to update the testing status. So that email address and who like need to be provided. And so in the emails, guys, generally when we send the emails, right, we CC our test manager. Okay. Here we may provide test manager email address, test manager. Okay. @Solitic. Okay. Whoever the test manager is there, right? His name @Solitic.com. Then your team members, okay? Let's say you are the test lead. Here I mentioned myself as the test lead. Under me, there are some people working, right? So let's say two people are working. Person one, okay? Tester one, tester two are working, let's say. Tester one @ Solitic. This is a company we're working for. So we have to Solitic.com. Tester two, who are the testers who are working, right? All those emails you have to provide in the CC. And this client email should be provided in the two and remaining will be in the CC like this, guys. Okay, somehow. Now, Solitic status update, the date, today's date is like 15th Jan 2021, the date you have to provide. Then hi, client name. Today we have performed the below task on this Tutorials Ninja web application, right? This is application, right? So we are testing this application, tutorialsninja.com/demo. So, what are the different tasks we have performed on this application? We have executing the test cases is one task. So here in the bracket, I can mention refer enclosed document. So just you can send the complete test cases document for the client review. Here I have attached the test cases document, guys, with our results. Then test execution results. Then testing by exploring the application. Not only we tested the application by executing the test cases, but also we performed, we explored the application for testing, okay? After executing the complete test cases, we started exploring the application because not all the defects you will get only by executing the test cases, guys. Sometimes, okay, not all the defects you get by executing, just by executing the test cases, you will not get all the defects. We have to even explore the application, guys. We'll get more defects. So your defects testing is equal to executing the test cases plus exploring the application in terms of testing, right? When you do all this stuff, you'll get the complete defects. Most of the defects you will get if you do this. If you skip this exploring the application for testing for identifying the defects, right? You will get only few defects, like 15 to 18 defects you may get. If you want to get the most of the defects, you have to do not only executing the test cases, but also you have to explore the application with an intention of identifying the defects, fine? So what are the, and also tasks, what are the different tasks you performed on this today? Executing the test cases, testing by exploring the application, reporting new defects. We have reported, let's say, 21. Generally, it doesn't happen, guys, okay? Every day you will send some status email with 5 defects, 6 defects, 10 defects, whatever it is. But 21 is too huge. But anyhow, I'm just putting it so that I want to put all the defects in this email, fine? Now, blockers. Blockers, coming to the blockers. So while executing the test cases, guys, we were not able to execute all the test cases, right? There were some test cases which were blocking, right? Because of some XYZ reasons, some test cases we are unable to test. We simply have put the status of those particular test cases as blocked, right? Neither pass nor fail. We have set it as blocked. These were the reasons, guys, okay? I just went through all the test cases we have executed and I've seen what are the test cases which were blocked, okay? I have collected all the reasons and I have put it here from the test case. From the test cases, I derived these blocked things, fine? So we were unable to execute few test cases due to the below blockers. Email system is not working. That was one blocker. Need information on different products and their weights. We are unable to check the we are unable to test whether the products that are added to the shopping cart have the proper weights or not, because client has not provided any information about different products and their weights. So this information is still in pending from the client. Once we receive this information, then only we can execute this particular test cases. Need coupon codes. So there were some situations where we can before we place the order, right, we can actually apply some coupon codes and get some discount. But since we don't have any coupon codes, valid coupon codes to apply, so we are unable to test few test cases. So this is the reason for blocker. And unable to purchase gift certificates. You see in the application, guys, as I already explained in the previous sessions, there is only one payment option, that is cash on delivery. Remaining payment options like credit card, debit card, and all those stuff are not there. So because of that, right, whatever the orders we are placing for purchasing these gift certificates are in processing state only. They are not completed. Okay. Once we pay only, then it will be completed, right? Once the payment is completed, once the order is successfully processed, right, then only we will get the gift certificates and then only we can redeem these gift certificates. There were some test cases where we need to redeem these gift certificates, right? There were some test cases where we need to apply these gift certificates and see whether whatever the amount is getting deducted or not from the new orders being placed. But that's not happening because we don't have a proper gift certificates having the completely processed orders, right? So these are the things, guys, which are blocking few of our test cases, and client need to reply on them, right? Whatever we need to do, right, the client has to reply. So based on the replies, we can execute this blocking test cases. Until then, these things will be blocked, but it's our duty to inform the client that we are unable to test few things because we need to highlight some problems, guys. Okay, not just by providing the test cases, your task will not be done, because client may not always be going through each and every test case provided in this test case document. It's our duty to provide separately, guys. Okay, if you want to highlight something, you just highlight in the email, guys. Okay, so the client will check. Then defects, we have found the below defects today, like around 21 defects, right? Whatever the defects we identified, right, like this, we can provide. Along with the severity, we can provide, okay? So all this defect ID, defect description, title or description, and severity of the defect, everything you can provide in this kind of table. In the one of the previous session, I showed you, right, how to create this kind of table and put into the email. By using the Excel, we can draft this kind of thing and copy from Excel to the Word. And from Word, we need to copy into the email so that you will get this kind of table into the email. Then the last one was task planned for tomorrow. Okay, task planned for tomorrow. Any new task assigned, guys. Okay, so what are you going to do tomorrow? So that is what is the thing all about. So here I will mention tomorrow morning we may get some email from the client, or We may get some tasks from the client side POCs or someone, right? So based on the emails, we can plan our tasks. Apart from that, if latest version is provided, if latest application version is provided, right, we will perform the below. We'll again have to execute the test cases, guys. This test cases were executed on particular version of the application. Now, if tomorrow, if you get another version of the application, okay, if the client or developers have provided a new version of the application, right, again, you need to execute all your test cases, guys. Don't think that once you executed the test cases, your job is done. It's not like that. You have to continue executing the test cases upon receiving the latest versions. How many number of times you receive the application version, right? That many number of times you need to execute the test cases. So as part of executing the test cases, guys, we need to perform retesting and regression testing. I'll tell you what is retesting and regression testing in the next session, okay? So if we get a new version, right? If we get a latest new version of this particular application, we can perform retesting and regression testing, okay? What are all this? I will explain the next session, okay? Till then, just don't worry about retesting and regression testing. And sometimes, guys, here, guys, I'm using my Gmail, okay, to show you how to draft an email to the client for sending this kind of details. So in your company, like sometimes you will be using some specific tools, guys, okay, like Outlook or something, okay? I don't know whether I have this Outlook or not in my machine. Let's search. No, there is no Outlook in my machine. So there's something like Microsoft, okay? Microsoft Outlook, an email client. This we call that as email client, guys, okay? So this is like it looks, Microsoft Outlook. So this is how, wait a minute. It's not there here. Yeah, this is how it looks, guys, okay? You see some email kind of, it's a email, okay? Email software, you can say, from the Microsoft. Apart from the Word, Excel, and you can also get Microsoft Outlook, guys. If your company is providing this Microsoft Outlook, right, this email client has a lot of benefits, guys. So if I have to put this table here, right, in this normal Gmail, if I have to send this particular, I have to put this table, right, then what I have to do, I have to go with some Excel, Microsoft Excel, then I have to design this table. I have to put all the data, copy the table into Word, Microsoft Word. From Word, I need to copy into this email. Then only I'll get this kind of structure. But if you are using, if you're in your company, if Microsoft Outlook is provided for you, right, you don't have to do all those stuff, guys, like Excel, Word, and all those stuff are not required. Directly, you have the options in the Microsoft Outlook email client where you can directly create the tables and write down the details. It will save a lot of time, guys, okay? Compared to the normal Gmail thing, right? If you have the Microsoft Outlook client, the preparation of this kind of emails is very easy, okay? So all the options required for drafting this kind of emails will be there in the Microsoft Outlook, and you can do that in very less time. So that's the importance, guys. That's a lot of other benefits are also there, okay? Even though internet connection is gone, you cannot access your Gmail if internet is gone, right? But sometimes if internet is also gone, Outlook will store your emails in offline mode. Okay, Microsoft Outlook will store your emails in offline mode. That means you can still access your emails even though there is no internet. Okay, so a lot of benefits are there with Microsoft Outlook. Let's not deviate, but so it's in real time, guys, when you are working on a project and you are sending some emails, right? Most of the cases, guys, your company will be providing such kind of email clients like Microsoft Outlook. Using them only, you will be sending the emails, okay, rather than like this. So simply you can send it, guys. Done. Fine, guys, this is all about this session where I explained how to draft an email with a list of defects and blockers, okay, as part of the continuation of our live project series. In the next session, I'll explain about retesting and regression testing and when we have to perform that and what exactly is retesting and what exactly is regression testing. I'll explain in terms of live project, guys, so that you can understand those terms in a better way. So that's it for this session, guys. Thank you. Bye.